Good morning, students. Is my voice audible? Students, is my voice audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Okay, ma'am. Students, I have uploaded Coursera course link in Moodle, but many of them are still they didn't register that course. So now, all of you registered this course, students? I'm giving you 10 minutes time. All of you go to this course. Link I have uploaded in Moodle, and here I am sharing screen. Students, go to Coursera and register for this course. Coursera account and register for this course. I have uploaded link in Moodle. CSE 146. Students, this is very, very important.
Yes, sir, it is a 5-week course, no, sir.
Pardon?
It is a 5-week course, no, sir.
5-week course. Yes.
100.
Yes, sir.
Yes, it is a.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, 19. Yes, sir. Stop sharing. Yes, CSE 323. Share your screen. Students, by this evening, I will get information from your department. So I will note on all your numbers. If you won't register in coming days, I will cut marks for the assignments and Coursera course. Very good, Amma. Stop sharing. So this is very, very important. So register now. I have uploaded a link in Moodle. CSE 513.
Yes, sir.
Share your screen. Okay, Amma. Right. CSE 534.
Yes, sir.
Share your screen. Okay, Amma. 59, shower ready.
Yes, sir.
Login aya babu, shower ready.
Ayan sir, the internet slow unnatundi sir, load
avutundi, but login avan, you have to register this course. Okay,
okay sir.
Right. CSE 737. Share your screen. Sai Pavan. CSE 916.
Yes, sir.
Share your screen. Students, everybody has to register Coursera course. I have uploaded link in Moodle. It is compulsory. But this evening I will get data from your department and I will note down all your numbers if you won't register. Okay, student. Thank you. CSE 953.
Sir, yes, sir.
share your screen.
Sir, I logged in on mobile, sir. Can I show in camera?
Yeah, no problem. Have you registered? Have you registered Coursera course? Okay, right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good, good. Right. CSC 1149.
Yes.
Share your screen. Okay, ma'am. Right. CSC 1160. Share your screen. Okay, ma'am. CSC 1341.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sharing it.
Share your screen. Yeah. Right. Okay, students. So inform to your classmates and CRs. Post a message in your classmates group that everybody has to register Coursera course, which is linked to the subject. It is very, very important, and by this evening they have to register. By this evening I will get the information data from your department. Okay, CRs, post in your respective sections WhatsApp groups that everybody has to register this course. Okay, right. And we are discussing signal conditioning for the resistive sensors. Do you have exam at 11 o'clock?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. I'll wind up by 11.
Yes, sir. Can you prepare now, sir?
Yes, student, your voice is not clear.
We have exam today, sir.
At 11 o'clock, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. By 10:45 or 10:40, I will wind up. We have only two topics only, very small topics, we will cover them. You can cover. Yes, yesterday in lab session, we have completed, we have discussed about instrumentation amplifier and Wheatstone bridge. Interference. So, interference is a phenomenon in which two waves form a resultant wave of greater lower. The interference is any electric signal present at the output of the system or circuit being considered and coming from a source external to it. So, if we are getting another signal and which is mixing up with our required signal, that is called interference. Interference problems are not exclusive for electronic measurement systems, but are also present in any electronic systems. Depending on the coupling method, is through a common impedance and electric field or magnetic field, we will respectively speak of respective capacitor and inductive interference. Because of multiple devices, we will get interference. Resistive interference. Here you can see we have a circuit with multiple resistors. You can see voltage sources are working And we introduced another resistor R3, the second resistor, to eliminate resistive interference. Most of the measurement systems face interference, so we can eliminate interference. We assume that the common mode voltage at the op amp input due to VI, that is input voltage, does not exceed the maximum allowed value. An instrumentation amplifier would provide increased CMRR, that is common mode rejection ratio. However, that the available CMRR is not high enough, or the common mode voltage is too high, or just that in addition to the input amplifier, there are other circuits connected to the same reference. CMRR means the common mode rejection ratio. If we apply same input at the two inputs, we will get a zero output. Yesterday also we have seen, for instrumentation amplifier, if two inputs are same, we are getting zero output. So we should not get any output if both inputs are same. Same with the differential amplifier also. So differential amplifier accepts two inputs. If we apply same input at the two inputs, it has to produce zero output. If it is producing some voltage as output, that we can understand we have an error in that circuit. Signal circuit grounding. A ground is a point or equipotential plane. That's a ground here. I will show you ground. Students, for any electrical circuit, we have to connect ground connection. These two represents ground. So that is very important for an electrical network or electronic circuit. When grounding a circuit or system, we must minimize the noise voltage generated by currents flowing between circuits through a shared impedance. We must avoid ground loops because they are susceptible to magnetic interference and to voltage differences between different grounding points. Figure shows three different grounding methods here. See. Single point series ground. Single point parallel ground here, second figure. Multiple point parallel ground. And respective currents and impedances, we have represented the equations. Different patterns of grounding. Series, parallel, and multiple grounding. So here, we have the circuit connections. Series grounding. In the series ground connection method, supply currents for each circuit produce drops in voltage that result in a different voltage reference for each circuit. This is called single point series grounding. Parallel grounding. Parallel grounding at a single point requires a more involved physical layout but overcomes the problem pointed out for series grounding. Here. Multiple grounding for high frequency circuits less than 10 megahertz. less than 10 megahertz. Multiple grounding points are preferred to single point grounding because a lower ground impedance is uptime. Ground plane impedance can be further reduced by plating its surface. So here we are using multiple parallel grounding, multiple point parallel grounding. And shield ground. Next pattern is shield ground. The shield of a conductor is effective only when it is connected to a constant voltage. When shielding amplifiers, the shield must be connected to the reference voltage for the enclosed circuit, whether it is grounded or not. Figure A shows the correct connection. If the shield were not connected or connected to a different voltage, there would be a parasitic feedback from the amplifier output to its input that could even lead to oscillations. So here we have a shield grounding. Figure B shows the case where the shield is left unconnected. If you observe, shield is connected here and shield is not connected here. Figure C shows the equivalent circuit. This circuit may oscillate because of the stray feedback path through C1S. Yeah. Stray feedback path means physically there is no connection, but because of some short circuit or because of some multiple components, we will get a stray feedback through CS1. Figure D shows that grounding the reference point for an amplifier when its shield is not connected does not reduce external interference VI. So this is figure D, and VA is the input voltage. The equivalent circuit figure E shows that coupling from VI to the shield is minimal when CS2 is very small. Here we have a connection between the shield and VI. Different types of groundings, different types of shield groundings here you can see. isolation amplifiers. An isolation amplifier is an amplifier that offers an ohmic isolation between its input and output terminals. Ohmic isolation means resistive type of isolation. This isolation must have a low leakage and a high dielectric breakdown voltage, that is high resistance and low capacity. Typical values for these are respectively 1 tera ohm and 110 peak value. Isolation amplifiers are interesting because instrumentation amplifiers withstand a limited common mode voltage, usually about 10 volts. Measurement situations and encountering high common mode voltage arise in obvious cases such as an high voltage device. So for a differential amplifier, if you apply large high voltages, sometimes they will produce some voltage as output. For lower voltages, it will show zero as output, but for higher voltages, instrumentation amplifier or differential amplifier, they'll show some output, which is an error. They may also arise in unsuspected cases as a sensor bridge supplied by more than 20 volts, or when two grounding points are involved whose voltage difference amounts to several tens of volts. In medical electronics, safety standards forbid making any connection to the patient's body leading to a dangerous current through him in the event of contact with the live conductor. In medical electronics, safety standards forbid making any connection to the patient's body leading to a dangerous current through him or her in the event of a contact with a live conductor. So this is a disadvantage. Isolation amplifiers, there is no ohmic continuity from the input reference terminal to the output reference terminal. The input common is also independent of the reference terminal of the power supply, that is supply common and supply ground. In some cases, the power supply is also independent from the output common. Signals supply power magnetically coupled from one part to another of isolation amplifiers by transformers with low interwinding capacitance. Signals and supply power are magnetically coupled from one part to another of isolation amplifiers by transformers with low interwinding capacitance. So all these are analog devices. So with the isolation amplifiers, so we have completed second module, student. You have to prepare complete module for the second module test. I will wind up class by 10:40. If you have doubts, you can ask me.
Yeah.